Hi students, in this video we are going to see properties of continuous time Fourier transform. So in a Fourier transform, we have two equations. One is the analysis equation and second is the synthesis equation. So we are having Fourier transform given by x of j omega integral minus infinity to infinity x of t e raised to minus j omega t dt. And another equation is x of t 1 upon 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity x of j omega e raised to j omega t dt. So the first equation that we have written is a Fourier transform. And the second equation is inverse Fourier transform. And we can represent this relationship like this: x of t, if you do Fourier transform, it will have x of j omega. So while analyzing any property of a Fourier transform, this will be the first statement. So let's repeat. So let's learn about different properties of a continuous time Fourier transform. So the first property is the linearity. So what linearity property says? If we are having a signal x of t whose Fourier transform you obtain as x of j omega, one more signal y of t is there whose Fourier transform is y of j omega, then a linear combination of these two, if I apply a times x of t plus b times y of t, we will get Fourier transform a times x of j omega plus b times y of j omega. So it's a quite simple property we are having. Whatever a constant we are having at the input side, same constant will get multiplied to the transform as well. So this is a linearity property. Let's go to the next property, that is time shifting. So what time shifting property says? If x of t having a Fourier transform x of j omega, then if you shift the signal by t0 amount, so it becomes x of t minus t0 plus Fourier transform is e raised to minus j omega t0 x of j omega. Let's prove this. So by definition of Fourier transform, the Fourier transform of x of t minus t0 will be integral minus infinity to infinity x of t minus t0 e raised to j omega t, rather e raised to minus j omega t dt. So we will get this signal. Now over here, what we can do, we can replace this t minus, this is the definition of a Fourier transform. But while finding a Fourier transform of this particular signal, what we'll do, we will use an inverse Fourier transform definition, meaning so inverse Fourier transform can be given as x of t equals 1 upon 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity x of j omega e raised to j omega t d omega, right? Now what I want is a Fourier transform of x of t minus t0. So what we'll do, we'll replace t by t minus t0 in this equation, and we'll get x of t minus t0 equals 1 upon 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity x of j omega into e raised to j omega t minus t0 d omega. So let's solve. So 1 upon 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity x of j omega, here it will be e raised to j omega t into e raised to minus j omega t0 d omega. So with respect to this, what we can do? We can rearrange the term properly in order to get a Fourier transform relationship. So what I will do over here, x of t minus t0, we'll write like this. It's 1 upon 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity. I will club these two terms together so that it will be e raised to minus j omega t0 multiplied by x of j omega into e raised to j omega t d omega. So this particular thing is a kind of a synthesis equation. Means what? Just compare with the standard synthesis equation, which is nothing but a inverse Fourier transform. Which says x of t is 1 upon 2 pi minus infinity to infinity x of j omega e raised to j omega t d omega. So if you see properly over here, I can say this particular waveform or this particular part of the equation is nothing but a synthesis equation for x of t minus t0. So from this, what I can say, x of t minus t0 Fourier transform will be e raised to minus j omega t0 into x of j omega. Once again, just focus on this synthesis equation. What is saying? X of t, if you do a Fourier transform, will get x of j omega. So you have to focus on this, x of t, x of j omega. So Similarly, over here, this part I can compare with this, and x of t is related with x of j omega with a Fourier transform. Hence, x of t minus t0 related with this part by a Fourier transform. So likewise, I can say if we do a shifting, we'll get this particular Fourier transform. Here, two observations we can make. And what are those two observations? If you see over here, we are getting just one phase added to the original signal. Means what? If you have a shift of a signal in a Fourier transform, the magnitude is not going to change. So the observation number one is the time shift property . So the observation we can draw from here is a signal which is shifted in time does not have the magnitude of its Fourier transform altered. That is, a magnitude of a Fourier transform of x of t is same as the magnitude of a Fourier transform of x of t minus t0. So I can say, if a Fourier transform of x of t is represented as x of j omega, which is nothing but mod of x of j omega e raised to j angle x of j omega. We have written this in terms of a polar form. Then Fourier transform of x of t minus t0 equal to e raised to minus j omega t0 x of j omega, which is same as mod of x of j omega, and we have angle e raised to j at an angle x of j omega minus omega t0. So here, what are the things we have to observe is, for both these signals, Fourier transform, the magnitude is remain same. And second observation is about the phase. So the angle will have this additional phase. So the second observation is, the effect of a time shift on a signal is to introduce into its transform of phase shift, which is minus omega t0, which is linear function of omega. So here we have seen a second property, which is a time shifting. So here we have seen two properties of a Fourier transform. One is a linearity, where whatever the constant we are multiplying to the input side, and whenever we are having an input as a linear combination of two different signals, same thing will be there in the output side as a Fourier transform. And the second property is a time shifting. So whenever we have a shifting, in a signal x of t in a time domain, we will get an extra term involved in it, and that is e raised to minus j omega t0. Two observations can be drawn here. Whenever we shift the signal in time domain, there won't be any effect as far as the magnitude of the Fourier transform is concerned. But yes, there will be a change in the phase. One additional phase shift will get added, which is a linear function of frequency omega. Thank you.